it's happening in New York, New Jersey, or Long Island.
Hear about it with Joe Piscopo.
Mornings 6 to 10 on AM 970. The Answer.
Jimmy, I'm learning this, by the way. I play the drums, Mikey does the guitar, and then we're going to go down to the Drift House and do the song. And I think I'll sing while I drum. Give it to me, Al. Come on, Glenn. David, listen. Give me, Albert, go ahead.
Listen here, baby.
Stop acting so crazy. Come on, I'm ready. David Burke, welcome back to the show, buddy. How are you, man?
I'm great.
You know Debbie Duhaime in person?
Yeah, I know her voice. Now I know her.
Hi. Look at this. And I know you have before me my favorite chicken that Bruce Springsteen loves as well.
Yes.
And you brought that in. Thank you so much. This is great. Then did you make this all today?
Last night,
you made all this, so it's good?
Yeah. Last night, I made everything last night because I can't get up that early.
That's the way you do it. And this is my favorite. Before we get to the eats of the day.
I didn't make that.
On camera, look at this. It's a David Burke cookie. The face of David. This is great.
Now, was this
this is a great idea.
Somebody gave him a guy named Peter Pants. From one of my investors and partner and great friend gave
that's
me that.
That's his real name?
Peter Pantaleano.
Oh,
Joey's cousin.
Joey Pants. Joey Pants.
Cousin.
That's an answer. Yeah. This is great. Look at that. Let me see if it's a likeness there.
That's
it. That's a good one. There you go,
I love it.
Hello. Hey, how are you?
And it came in handy because I forgot somebody's birthday. Dear friend of mine, so I put this
great
on top
idea.
Of about
that's great.
Six cupcakes,
that's
a lot of powdered
great.
Sugar
that is
out the
great.
Door.
Wait, now you have a receipt there. Are you submitting the receipt?
I needed a reference point. I went shopping.
Because if you seriously give us 2-3 months, we may get to it at the station. I have a whole bag of receipts.
You're gonna count it. You're gonna see if this adds up to a whole zucchini.
Did you go to a regular? You went to a regular.
Very stressful for me.
You don't generally go to a regular store. You have distributors,
never.
Of course. So tell me.
And I don't eat at home, so I don't ever shop.
But you wanted it to be like every man, every woman. So you went to a regular grocery store.
And took my wedding ring off. Of course. I don't have a wedding ring.
You're cheating on me. That's the way it's doing, man. Oh, are you married? Oh, no, apparently not.
Yeah. Oh, this little thing?
You're the worst. That's what they say.
My dear grandmother, rest her soul.
He's worse than I am. But that, in this supermarket, you can meet wonderful people sometimes. Huh?
Yes. Well, yeah. I mean, they're pretty crowded. I mean, you can't help but bump into
But don't you get recognized?
You
people must recognize you.
Yep.
And you, Chef Burke? And you go, yes, I am. How are you? And what is your name?
No, it's me and Shelly went. And Shelly was taking pictures. Yeah. Some people were getting really annoyed that she was blocking the aisle. I mean, like, rude. Shelly
really?
Didn't notice
really?
It. I noticed it because they were behind her. And
oh,
I could
come
see
on.
The comments.
Yeah.
I was like, it's going to be a peach fight. I said.
They do. They go, oh, my God. Because it should be, supermarkets should run like the cars. You go in the right lane, you pass on the left, right?
It's so crowded. Trader Joe's was great, but in New York City, the real estate, I mean, the lines run through the shopping aisles. There's not like a separate area for lines. The lines run through the frozen food section. So if you were looking for something frozen, you got to like, trying to go through an airport, you know, cutting through the lines.
Yeah.
But it moves quick. Food's great.
So tell me you don't usually shop. This is very interesting. Because I do. Al does too. We go to the supermarket.
Yeah.
I do that. Debbie, I'm like that. I go to ShopRite. Mm-hmm. I go bonsai shopping, I call it.
Most chefs are never in a supermarket.
That's crazy.
Unless you're on a reality show or you have a family and that's what
so
you're
So what was your
day.
Impetus here? Just to
it's great
just to get to in touch with the people, David Burke?
It's good because you see.
Or to meet somebody. Did you meet somebody?
Well, we did a test on how much we
Forget
could make.
Forget eHarmony. Go to the supermarket. No, I'm sorry. I'm just kidding.
Especially if you're a reckless carriage driver.
Banging carts into other people. Oh, excuse me. What do you got in there?
Yeah.
Hi. Do you know who I am?
Don't even get me started with the.
You know who I am? Hey, you know what? All you got to do is go, hi.
Hi.
I have my own cookie. I love this, man.
That's funny.
So, Frankie, we can submit this receipt? Sure.
So I went there.
You'll never see the money, David. Sorry. No, it's okay. No, go ahead. Please.
I wanted to see it. I did this a few years ago back in Bergen County. We did something on how a family could afford to eat or what it would cost a week for a family to afford to have decent, nutritious meal. Mm. If it was possible versus being on food stamps.
Yeah, good for you, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And whatever it was, the allocation was 40, I forget what the number was. But anyway, we went out and did that again today. Forget the food stamp part. This is just to what it's like to... How economical can be to shop smart, seasonal, and feed your family.
So,
so I spent $44 yesterday.
You're kidding? On all of this?
Wow. I still have more.
Really?
Wow. Yes.
Wow. You did good.
Yeah.
So you were
I got
careful.
Got two phone numbers.
You go.
Really well.
They said, hey, this guy's a catch. He can cook and he's thrifty.
Oh, yeah.
I like
that's
it.
I said, you see what you got there in that basket of yours? We can make magic.
You never know. You never know.
What a line. I love it.
Never know you're from Jersey, David.
That's fine.
Just would never know.
So what I did was I bought a whole chicken.
We've lost control already. I'm sorry?
I just went out
well,
and
here,
said.
If I can't, may I? Can you get that, George? You get that nice shot? This is my favorite David Burke meal. He makes his chicken that this is not unlike what you make at Tavern 62.
It's all in the technique. Yeah. It's not shaped the same because I did it for home use.
Yeah.
But yeah, we soaked it in a little brine and roasted it.
It's just chicken breast is what.
Two breasts and four drumsticks. That was a pack
beautiful.
I bought for like $10.
Really?
That was a package, you know, like...
Really?
You know, I don't remember exactly how much. It wasn't more than $10.
Yeah.
I got
I have a plate, and if you're listening, I have a plate. It's got greens
pasta.
Around it, and it's got beautiful chicken breasts, and you have chicken legs, right? All together, way you make everything.
So here's what I did. I took the chicken. It's raw. I put it in a pot with water and vegetables and canned tomatoes. I poached the chicken.
You poached it.
I made chicken soup first. Pulled the chicken out and then broiled it.
Wow.
So I got
my
two
gosh.
Dishes now. The soup is in that container right there.
So
I made soup. I cooked all the chicken meat in water with veggies and tomato.
Wow.
So I made this soup.
Yeah, see, it was
and
soup,
this,
Al.
So this is
wow, with
minestrone,
all vegetables
basically.
In it.
Now,
oh, my. So you, that made, that was
I
the...
made all of this yesterday. Wow. I bought all the zucchini, yellow squash, peas, onions, tomatoes.
And that is that what you soaked the chicken in originally?
No, I soaked the chicken in water, sugar, and salt. That I didn't buy.
Water, sugar, and salt.
Now, but I poached it here, so I got flavorful broth. Soup, broiled this, boiled some pasta. Got tons of pasta. So I took some of the soup, mixed it with the pasta. That's for another day.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. But like if you're home, you could just
I
put
use
it in
some
your
of the pasta here.
Let me see. Oh, this is beautiful.
So now I have like a pasta, you know, a minestrone or some sort of. Now I can push this all in there.
This is great. This
or serve that as a pasta.
Big bowl of pasta.
Listen, there's no butter or cheese in here yet. Healthy.
Yeah. Is that right?
There's no butter or cheese in this initiative. So we're staying healthy. This is tomato, onion. I bought polenta cake already made. Cooked it.
Thanks, Frank.
Diced watermelon, roasted corn salad.
So,
this I would charge you $35 in a restaurant for.
Yeah, I'm telling you, but
alone, just the salad.
But you're telling me it's cost effective.
Cost effective.
So it's on a piece of a rectangle platter, wooden
platter.
But
that platter, was four tomatoes.
And it's long, and it's
they
got,
have these polenta sausages. They look like you cut
them
up.
Yeah, you cut them up, and they're divided by tomato, and what else is in
I
there?
I had onions, but I left them in the car. But tomato, onion, polenta cake.
Is that Parmesan on the top?
Parmesan, a little bit of roasted corn, and watermelon diced. That's a great salad. And there's more lettuce and all that. And then I made a green salad, spinach, tomatoes. Again, this is all...
Thank you, Debbie.
You know, and if you look at... And then I made some roast sweet potatoes.
Wow.
Sweet potatoes
are
half the price of regular potatoes.
Wait, whoa, hold on.
And they're healthy, right?
They are. They really are.
And I bought corn on the cob that was like 50 cents, 25 cents a
cob. Jersey corn?
Potatoes were 75 cents a pound, which is...
So again, I have a beautiful...
So if you go a little seasonal, shop a little bit, and all of a sudden... It goes a long way. And then, you know, I mean, I have technique in my head. I know what I'm doing. But a little bit of tip of poaching your chicken, making soup before you broil. Why just put a chicken in the oven and roast it when you can poach it first, save that broth for soup, tighten it up with pasta, bean. You need your protein. You need your meat, right? Meat, fish.
Yeah.
Or chicken, fish, maybe.
Yeah.
You need that. Then you need a base. Base could be sweet potatoes, pasta, rice, or beans. Mm-hmm. And then you stretch all the greens and load it up with veggies.
So this looks like it'll last almost a week, yo.
This took me no time because I gave it to six of my chefs. No, but this, I mean, once the stuff is cooking, a little bit of chocolate. But now if I did this on a Sunday, I have food till Wednesday and good picking food. And I could combine this with the leftover chicken and make
a salad
sandwich.
With the chicken.
I got pasta.
But
I still have more stuff in the back. in the front room there that I didn't bring. I still got twice as much salad.
For $44?
$44. You got it. At Trader Joe's.
How the heck did you possibly do that? I don't walk out of there for less than $200.
I wore a big coat.
This salad looks great. What is the
watermelon? I took a water. There was a whole watermelon.
Whoa. This green. This is regular spinach.
Romaine.
Yeah.
And then I chopped up watermelon with olive oil and vinegar. I didn't buy
it. Looks
the
like tomato. Little tiny tomatoes.
Looks like that's tomatoes. Watermelon. But it's watermelon. Yeah, that's a nice surprise as well. I added some here.
That is beautiful.
I even got a little cheese now. I got.
Oh man.
Shaved cheese is cheaper than grated.
Oh.
And you should buy it in a block. Instead of having it
well, no, they cut it for me, but it was a little. You don't need a pound of palm. Again, if you're cooking at home, it's not going to waste.
Yeah.
So some of this money will go to the next meal, and to the next meal, right. You build your pantry.
Yeah, this
but
is
this
great.
Is fun stuff.
Do you
for
have
me.
A book on this, Dave? Is this a? This is, you have
one
a book?
Of my books is based on second day dishes. Is basically shopping.
Yeah. Yeah.
Making a great classic American dinner for your family and then wanting to do with the leftovers. Yeah, and the leftovers you tend to get more creative with because you already paid for it. Mm-hmm. It's not a waste.
Debbie, mm-hmm. may I, Debbie? Because this is my favorite food. You know, I got to tell you something. Get serious for a second. Mm-hmm. When I had a thyroid cancer, and Al knows this too well, they always tell you eat everything orange, everything green and orange. Oh, yeah, it's an anti-carcinogen. It'll fight the cancer. Sweet potatoes, my doctor, and I remember the guy's name, Marvin Belsky from New York, said sweet potatoes are it. Sweet potatoes. This is gold. The sweet potato is one of the greatest foods ever, and it really helps you fight disease because of all the good things in it that will fight the carcinogens that are in your body. So tell me what you did. Did you take a full You baked the potato, and then, or did you cut it up raw and then cook it later?
And baked it.
Because I have a beautiful silver platter, a long oval platter with some spinach on it, but with cut up sweet potato that looks.
We baked it in a little bit of olive oil, salt, and pepper.
Forget it. David, you know, I can eat this. I'm going to eat this.
Even a baked sweet potato instead of a baked potato?
Come on, get a picture with David. There it is. That sweet potato. That's it.
There
it is. There
you go.
That pause was me pointing like my kids always tell me.
And those potatoes now you can heat them up, use them as croutons on your salad instead of bread.
Oh, wow.
You know, sweet potato croutons.
God, that's so good.
See, now, I wouldn't have thought of that because I love croutons on my salad, but that's a great idea.
David, you are so good because I am so picky. You know I am. This is spectacular. Yeah. Sweet potatoes cut up in little chunks like this.
And even yogurt on top of that instead of sour cream.
There you go.
Even a baked sweet potato, like a baked potato.
But you cut it up.
Yogurt.
You cut it up before you cook it.
I did.
Okay.
You don't have to.
And what'd you do? Bake it?
Like, olive oil, salt, pepper. You know,
like in the pan.
And then when it was cool and I threw some raw veg spinach in it and it melted it, wilted it, and that was it.
Guys, you're witnessing something that I would order and that I would eat.
See,
and
this is economical and
can
still
I steal
fancy.
This, sure.
It looks very fancy, yeah.
Can I have the chicken too? I'm gonna eat that. See,
yeah, you can.
Because I don't have to eat the. I got a big crazy day. I'm going on doing some news hits today. I'm gonna go on my David Burke.
There's a lot of news going on today. There's a lot of stuff.
Yeah, well, you can't make it up. But you know what's so good? We're gonna make true. I can't stand it.
So you mentioned you want to play in the. You're gonna play
that. So this is it. I gotta tell you, Debbie. David has a drift house down the shore.
Yes,
Seabright.
Yes. So we're going to go down.
We're
going
to go. Beautiful restaurant.
Yeah, so I heard restaurant. You went.
I said, it's kind of a beach thing. Bruce is known to stay in the area. Bruce and John Bon Jovi. I said, let's do a band thing. So we're going to put a band together. Mikey and I, I think the end of this week, David, we're going to get together. We're going to rehearse a little bit. We're going to put the whole band together. And then we're going to pick. We may have the band already in South Jersey to bring with us.
Yeah.
Boom. And we'll just go in there. We'll have a great night, you know?
Be great.
We should do it on Friday night. You said October's better?
Yeah, I think first we got October because we're launching a little bar out on the pier there called Naughty Bar.
Oh, yeah, right.
That's part of Drift House. Part of
Drift House. This is great, man.
How was your steaks? Did you guys take the steaks on?
I had the strip steak Friday night. I had the filet on Wednesday. Phenomenal. Salt, pepper, a little bit of garlic. That was it. Unreal. Tremendous.
You have an event at September 13th at your Garden City property, don't you?
Sporting event, Thursday night.
What's it? What's going on?
I don't have all the details, but it's out in the patio. There's going to be like some kind of not illegal gambling, some kind of betting and things like that.
Not illegal.
I don't have all the details on the drinks. It's going to probably be like football type snacks and stuff. I guess
because Thursday night football.
Night?
Yeah, that is opening night for Thursday night football.
Yeah, so it'll be like Thursday night football.
Where's it going to be?
Garden City Hotel at the patio. I also brought back, I was going to bring it in today. I bought my first lawn jockey up in Saratoga.
Oh, is that right?
Those guys?
Yeah. Yeah.
I hope it was white. I hope it was white. That's what.
That's terrible.
Really. Just make it white, no matter what. You're gonna run into trouble.
Can I real quick before we have to let you go? You brewed collaborated on a beer with Sam Adams. Oh, yeah, is that right? I read that somewhere.
I made the Burke in a Bottle. It was cool.
Right, and
five
it was,
years we did five different beers.
Wow,
quickly he got Jim.
Jim Cook, yeah.
The best guy.
Oh, he's great. He's great.
So I make this grilled beef heart beer.
That was it.
Right. It was beef hearts. Where we grilled the beef hearts, put it in with the brew.
Wow.
He comes, the beer. We do the social media. He comes, he calls me up, and he said, I met him. He goes, we have more complaints from PETA.
Oh, my gosh.
Any complaint we ever had, he goes, congratulations. I love that.
Awesome. Goes, well, David Burke, the one, the only. Yeah, check us out online if you would at am970theanswer.com, am970 The Answer, but online YouTube and Facebook, you can see this wonderful cuisine. And this is costly. I love that you're thinking of regular folks, those of us who do our own shopping. And this is an economical way to really eat well. And I got my sweet potatoes. This food's all coming to me today. And
it's fine. Go ahead, eat.
Debbie, you're more enough to welcome to join.
I'm on a yogurt and vegetable diet for the last 3 weeks.
Oh, you look great though, but yogurt.
I lost 5 pounds, and whey protein. That's what my doctor said. 3 weeks now.
Yeah, is that right?
Yeah,
feel good.
All right.
I feel pretty good.
But when you're cooking, I know you. You just
it's the picking. Look how much I picked this right now.
Yeah.
I'm paying attention to the some of the healthier items.
Mm-hmm. But the steaks were great, thank you. And the cookware is spectacular. I keep telling
Harold,
you.
Oh, Harold. Oh, he was thrilled last week.
Yeah, he was.
He listens every week. Hi, Harold.
Let me tell you, Harold, the 822, we're going to go. But I got to tell you something. When I cook on this cookware, Debbie, you got to get some of this cookware, this David Burke cookware. Because when I'm in the rush in the morning, and you said, do I eat French toast every morning? Generally, but sometimes I get so tired of it. It's like when I'm running out of the house, it's David Burke cookware, Pam spray, which you don't even need because it's ceramic base on the cookware. Two eggs, boom. I scramble the eggs right in the cookware. No scratching or anything. Ceramic like I've never seen before.
Wow.
Even cooked, boom, so quick like that. Kudos on that, David.
And no dirty pan when you come home.
Yeah, that's exactly right. I'm a bachelor, so I don't even wash it. I just keep it right there in the stove, man, you know? Hey, let's go shopping together.
When the pan starts growing a beard, let me know.
It is. David, God bless you. Thank you. Shelley Goldberg, thank you for all the trouble of this beautiful cuisine right there.
Thank you.
Everybody knows this guy. No, everybody knows he can do a radio show. Joe Piscopo. Mornings, 6 to 10 on AM 970. The Answer.